Welcome back to Pokemon Heart Gold, the second member of the Elite Four. This is Koga. I totally spaced that out previously, but as you can see, I got my Hitmontop ready. This guy just freaking says the same thing that he does the first time, so I'm not even gonna bother reading it. And I'm kind of worried about him, in all honesty, just because he has Toxic, and that could be absolutely devastating. I just really hope that my Hitmontop is, powerful enough. He's only level 58, but he does have Earthquake, which is what I'm... There it goes, Toxic! I knew that was gonna happen. But I'm gonna be heavily relying on Beyblade here, and Earthquake's power. I probably should've seen if I had an item that ups ground-type moves and given it to him, but... You know, I'm not perfect and I forgot. But you know, more than halfway down, that's fine. If I take out the Skuntank in this turn, which it used Dig, doesn't this like double Earthquake's power if they use Dig? But after this, this is gonna be good. Do I kill him? I'm just gonna heal off the poison and then carry on. And if I have to, I will use Meat Shields. And it was a critical hit too, that was completely overkill. But I'll use Meat Shields if I have to. Meat Shields just being a Pokemon that I know is gonna just go down in one hit. And I'm actually gonna switch because I don't wanna deal with that Crobat. Crobat's poison and flying, so, and I think, pretty sure Hooters has a psychic type move. If it's gonna be enough, I don't know. I really doubt it if he's gonna one hit KO this thing, but you know, I can try. This might be the easiest battle. I know that Crobat is ridiculously fast, so. Great, it's using Fly, that's fantastic. Whatever. Too bad I could have used that turn to like heal off the poison off of Beyblade, but oh well. Things happen. I didn't know that he was gonna use Fly. I've actually never seen this Crobat use Fly before, I don't think. But holy crap! What is going on? Are you kidding me? Wow, okay. You do that, Crobat. That was so cool of you. I'm glad you could one-hit KO my Noctowl. You are an asshole. And of course you're gonna use frickin' Fly again. Why did I think that you weren't going to? Why did I think that this Guillotine was a good idea? I'm gonna try to use it again because I really don't like this Crobat. And I said Crobat really weird. I don't like this Crobat due to its sheer speed, and of course the Guillotine did not work. I'm going to assume that he's gonna fly again. And I'm going to use one of my many revival herbs on Noctowl, because I don't want to have to deal with using like a revive and then healing it up again the next turn, because revives only recover half of their HP. And of course, he uses Fly again, and I'm actually, hopefully this doesn't get a crit. I'm gonna try for the Guillotine again, because I just want to get rid of this Crobat, and obviously Noctowl cannot do that. And of course, the Guillotine missed again. Great. I've had such good luck with it in the past, and then now it's just not, it's not doing it. And that makes me pretty sad. I'm gonna heal up Queen there really fast, because I kind of don't want Queenler to die, because I really want this Guillotine to work. Because this Crobat is really annoying with its Fly, and if I can just get this Guillotine off, I will be really happy. Because I'm not... I don't think I should really be too concerned with his other Pokemon. This thing is giving me a lot of trouble, though. And I'm... missed again! Well, at least this time I can, still have hiccups, that's great. I can finally heal off the poison on Beyblade and get rid of that. And something, I don't know if like the poison, if the strength resets. This is my last Guillotine, so hopefully this works. If it doesn't, that sucks. But I don't know if the poison damage resets if you switch out a Pokemon. And of course, it missed. None of them hit. That is fantastic. So I guess I will just heal up and try to beast through this thing slowly but surely. And watch, this is gonna be one of the Pokemon that I'm gonna get down. It's like, he's gonna be in the red because I couldn't just like two-hit KO him. I had to like three-hit because like my two hits like barely would not do enough damage. And he's gonna heal up. It's gonna be one of those scenarios, and I'm gonna rip my hair out because this Crobat needs to die. I thought this fight was gonna be fairly easy, and that was obviously not the case. Let's see how much this does. If I remember correctly, Crobat doesn't have the best defense. He sure does not. And I critical hit! That was so good! I like how I miss all of my guillotines when I could have just crab hammered it and hopefully got a critical hit and just one hit KO'd it anyway. So that was great. I'm gonna have to use like a berry, like a lava berry or something to get his the moves back. And Hooter's actually really level there. Pretty good. Swalot. I will switch back to Beyblade. It's probably just gonna like instantly use Toxic. Because that's what all of his Pokemon do. That is what they are meant for. I think Swalot has pretty good defense, I think. I could be extremely wrong, but we'll see how this Earthquake does. If I can get him to like a little under half, that would be perfect. Just like I got his first Pokemon down to. But that is not going to happen, and he used Yawn. Oh well, I can get off another Earthquake, and he has a berry? Leftovers? He has leftovers, that's great. So he's another Earthquake, and then I'll fall asleep, and then he's probably gonna heal. He has not healed yet because he hasn't had the chance to, so I'm gonna assume that he's gonna heal, unless his leftovers recover enough to make him feel safe. But I'm gonna fall asleep there. So, I'm gonna use an Awakening really fast. He has a stupid leftovers. Is that gonna... Didn't bring him up to yellow. It's pretty high red, though, so I don't know if he's gonna heal or not. Hopefully he does. I'm kinda hoping that he does, although the Swalot's probably just gonna use another Yawn. But, let's see. What is he going to do? He is going to heal. I figured. It's kind of whatever, though. I don't really mind too much. Swalot does not seem like a big threat at this point. I don't know if I'm gonna regret saying that, but so far he doesn't seem too threatening. He can put me to sleep and he could probably poison me. I don't know his other moves. I guess we'll probably see, though. Sludge Bomb. Alright, let's see how much this does. It's probably gonna badly poison me, too. I wouldn't be surprised. Nope, it didn't. It actually doesn't do a ton of damage. It did quite a bit, but I'm faster than it. If I can get off this Earthquake, and if this thing doesn't kill me, and if he doesn't heal again, there's a lot of factors that are introduced into this on whether or not I will take down this Pokemon. So hopefully he doesn't crit. If he crits, I'm probably dead. He did not crit. There's his leftovers. I am not poisoned. And it's another Earthquake. He did not heal. Alright, I don't know if another move, if one of my fighting type moves or my steel type move would have taken him down. I just wanted to be safe because I didn't want him to like barely have any HP left and then kill Beyblade or anything. But alright, there goes his Swalot, which is probably kind of tanky. Venomoth, we'll switch and I will use Ginger Snap because you are a bug, I think. Bug poison? I don't know if Venomoth is like a flying poison either. I thought he was a bug poison, but I could be wrong. I'm pretty sure... I always thought like... I don't know if it was just me, but I always thought that... Oh no! This guy is a jerk. Now I remember this. At least I got first tech. But I don't know if it was just me, but I always like thought when I was younger or something that ice moves were super effective against Venomoth. And apparently they aren't, and I one-hit KO'd anyway, good job! But yeah, ice moves are definitely not super effective against it, so I think it's bug poison, I think. And I will actually... who do I want to send out for this? Beyblade is pretty... he is pretty not looking good. Honestly, don't know. What are my spider's moves? What do you have? Bug Bite, Poison Jab... I honestly don't remember all of the poison type's weaknesses. So, I think he's like poison fighting too. So I'm honestly not sure. Probably be best just to switch to Beyblade, but I'm actually gonna stay in as Ginger Snap, because Beyblade is pretty weak. His Toxic Rope probably knows like Poison Jab and Toxic and Earthquake. Oh crap, I think he knows Earthquake. Wait, I just remembered that. That was fantastic. He's probably gonna like one-hit KO me with Earthquake. I totally spaced that out. That did Gunk Shot. How much is this gonna do? Is it super effective? I didn't think it was, but apparently it is. No, it's not. It just does a crap ton of damage. But I'm faster than him, so he's going to die. Which is fine by me, because that thing does a massive amount of damage. I wasn't expecting that. And, also, some of you might be, like, screaming at me, like, you can tell by the noises if something is super effective or not. And to that, I say I don't have my headphones in, because it's really loud. I need to get a new pair of headphones, because the ones that I have, they don't have, like, a volume switch thingy to, turn down the volume with the headphones. And if I turned it down, like, in my audio mixer or whatever, then it would just be really quiet in the recording, and I don't want that. But, right now I'm just gonna heal up my Hitmontop. So hopefully Hitmontop can power through this. Ugh, this muck is probably gonna use Minimize. I just keep thinking of things like, yeah, I knew it was gonna use Minimize. Great. Super excited about that. That's just fantastic. I'm gonna try to use Extrasensory. And I missed. Great. Hooters is just gonna stay in until Hooters cannot survive any longer. I don't know if this is a good idea or not, and this is the last Pokemon. At least I got Extrasensory off. I don't know how much this is gonna do. Hopefully a good deal, because it's a poison type and it's super effective, but that barely did anything. And he's just gonna continue to use Minimize. That was great. It's gonna take me like 4 hits to kill this thing. And what, does he have Black Sludge? Yes, he does! Oh my god. Does Shadow Ball hit every time? I don't know if it does. It might. I honestly can't remember. I'm too lazy to look up the info. But whatever, I will take the special defense. Oh no, no Swagger too? Are you kidding me? And now, this is gonna be like probably kind of weird to some of you, but now that whenever I see Swagger, I think of the wrestler Jack Swagger. I don't know how many of you watch wrestling or not, but I've started getting back into it. When I was like a little girl, my brothers would always watch it, and I would like watch too sometimes. I wasn't really into it though, too much, because I was just like a little girl. I didn't understand what was going on. There was just like random sweaty men wrestling, and it just didn't really appeal to me at all. It was just weird. But now I've been like getting back into it, and I've been watching DVDs that were from, like, we've watched old ones that were from like the mid to late 90s and stuff like that. Then recently I've been watching newer ones. Like, I just recently got done watching SummerSlam 2010, and apparently Shadow Ball does not hit every time, so that's fantastic. And he's gonna use Toxic on me, and by the time that Hooters dies, this guy's gonna be like full health. And that does not sit well with me. But since he's gonna sit there and be a jerkbag, I'm just gonna use Extrasensory again, and I'm gonna miss, and he's probably gonna die this turn. Or not, he's gonna use Minimize and not kill me, because he likes watching me suffer. I find this funny, because I thought that this was gonna be a pretty easy battle, and oh man, I was wrong. So I figured, you know, I got Earthquake, and this guy is like, he's minimized 6 times now. This guy has like max freaking evasiveness stat, and this is starting to become really irritating. And so I hiccup again. And he has full health! I called it. This isn't gonna hit. Nope. And I'm gonna die. Oh my god. This is... why is this even happening? Oh man. Well, there goes Hooters. Hopefully. Probably not though, but hopefully Beyblade will be able to pull through, which I doubt it. Like I said, I only have 3 Earthquakes and they're like all gonna miss. Alright, he avoided the first one. I don't see how. He is a pile of sludge. And I guess he just, I don't know, I guess the Earthquake just didn't affect him because of his, like, gelatinous state. I don't know, but if I can get this earthquake off. Oh, I did, and my attack is like raised. This better one-hit KO. If this isn't one-hit KO, I'm gonna be extremely disappointed. I will be so sad if this is now one-hit KO. Super effective. Okay, good. Thank God. I was about to say, it's super effective. My attack stat was like dramatically increased and stuff. I was gonna be super disappointed. But luckily, Beyblade pulled through and did not attack himself in his confusion. But there we go. There's Koga, which is so far the longest battle at like 15 and a half minutes. That was ridiculous. Great. Conduct Storm put your abilities to the test. Alright, after that long and painful battle, we will hopefully do a little better in the next room against Bruno, but you know, I doubt it, just like all the other times. So, hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part. Bye!